Travagirl, welcome to Afternoon Express. It's a Tuesday, so it's our favorite day of the week. We get to cook along in the kitchen. Now, I've been MIA from the cook along in the kitchen for a while, so I'm really, really excited to be back in here. And I hope that all of you caught the season premiere of Tropica Island of Treasure Maldives last night. It promises to be the most exciting and nail-biting season yet, and I'm told a bit spicy. And today, we're lucky enough to sit down with the consumer contestants to chat about their experience of arriving on the island for the first time. So for today's cook along though, we're taking on a summery trip to the Mediterranean with a delicious yet healthy meze platter. Clem is gonna take us through it.
So we're going to Turkey with a nice stuffed turkey flatbread. It is spicy, but I think the trend has been kind of spicy since the beginning of the year. We're loving it. So we're gonna do that and a deep fried cauliflower. And then I've even made a little, like, a dip at the end. It's gonna be really, really spicy. It's gonna be delicious.
Would you say that, like, people have found really new and exciting ways to cook cauliflower lately?
Yeah, because
it's almost, like, made this huge return.
It really has. You would think that the trend died down 2 years ago, but it's still going crazy. And this is another exciting way to prepare it.
I'm just glad we're not stuck pouring white sauce over cauliflower.
I'm not hating the cauliflower.
You're not hating
white
it?
Sauce.
No. Okay. I hope none of you are offended by So if you want today's recipe and shopping list sent to your device, simply SMS the keyword eat to 33650. SMSs are R1.50 each, and no free SMSs apply. As always, we're streaming live right now on YouTube, so you can keep your device handy in the kitchen and follow along live. At any point during the show, call in live on 021-430-9881. And if you get stuck along the way, or if you just want to chat or have some questions for our special guests or some tips on how we're cooking. And speaking of today's cook along guest, he won the hearts of the nation last year when he became the winner of season 2 of The Voice South Africa. An economics and politics graduate, he had no formal musical training, and singing on the national stage was his first attempt at performing since high school. Now, he sits with a huge record deal and recently launched his debut album, Restless. It's Craig Lucas.
And here's some things I notice. You're quite shy, but like to swag it up. Starting with your peak, I point her up, and for the hell of it, chewing on your gum, chewing when you do make up, it all makes sense. You listen to my favorite songs, I'm jealous that you're seeing them. It's clear to me you're driven when you talk about your studying. Think it's cool to kick it with your mom and not with your friends. And maybe I should stop before I freak you out. So I said this, you probably forget this. So for now, just let this be your song. Let this
What a voice. And welcome to Afternoon Express.
Thank you for having me.
So good to finally have you here. Your story is one that we've all heard before, but it's such a beautiful story and such a beautiful rise to fame and success. So as a young boy, I heard that you were really shy, really introverted.
Still am.
Really?
Still am, yeah.
What does that feel like, especially knowing that you've got this great talent that you've got to share with the world, but you've got this crippling fear of people and speaking in public?
It was really frustrating. I struggled for a really long time, and The Voice was sort of where I told myself, I'm going to do this, and this is probably the biggest stage I'll ever get on, and I'm either going to sink and swim. And I sort of did that partly out of anger, because I knew that I couldn't do it. And I was like, I'm going to enter The Voice. If I make it, great, and if I don't, I'm going to give up on music, because I can't struggle for that long. So I know I love to do it, but I just physically couldn't actually do it.
Wow, that's so sad, but I'm pleased that you kind of overcome it.
Yeah.
So now, tell me, what were you like as a young boy? Where did you grow up, and what was your life like?
I grew up in Elsie River. My mom still stays there, so I stay with her when I'm down in Cape Town.
Lovely. Hello, Elsies.
Yeah. I was pretty quiet. I'm being very shy. Threw myself into my books, because sort of that required the least amount of social sort of
interaction.
Exactly. So I was a bit of a nerd all the way up until matric, and then onto varsity as well. But music was always in the background. I always knew it was something that I wanted to do.
What kind of music did you used to listen to as a kid?
All kinds, particularly my mom's favorite kind of music. So she's a big fan of Queen and the Carpenters and Celine Dion.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
Your mom's got a good taste in music.
She does. And that sort of influenced the music I then listened to growing up, because I tend to find myself listening to female singers, people with sort of weird voices, people that aren't really mainstream too much.
And I was wondering what kind of influence you had, and it obviously comes from your mom, because the song that you auditioned at The Voice with was from The Animals.
Yeah.
And you've got to give us a little a cappella just to remind our audience.
Sure, so it went, there is a house in New Orleans, they call the rising sun.
Oh, what a voice. Okay, so that happened on stage. Because you were actually going to audition for a previous season of The Voice.
Yeah.
And then you decided, no ways, I can't do this, I'm too shy. What happened there?
Yeah, so I've been a big fan of The Voice since, it started with Holland, right? And so I watched The Voice, I watched it on YouTube, and then
it was
in America.
And it was on SABC,
sure. And then season one came, and I was like, I've been waiting for this all my life, and I'm going to enter, and... as I usually do, I chickened out.
You should have entered that one, because wasn't Arno Carstens one of the judges?
I think he was on the show, but he wasn't a judge, per se.
Oh, okay.
And then a friend of mine actually entered season one, and he got really far, and he then told me, whether or not you win the show, every single day you learn so much, and the singer you are when you leave compared to when you entered, the light is apart. And I was like, then this is exactly what I needed. And he then went and entered my name. And he was like, look, you've got a 5-minute audition. You've got nothing to lose, so just go for it.
Incredible. So from being an economics and politics student to entering this competition that literally changed your life, I assume, how did your life change at that moment?
Well, I do music full-time now, which is what I've always wanted to do. I also struggle. The thing with music is if you don't really know anybody in the industry, it's quite hard to get in. And so I'd written all the songs over the years, and I couldn't get them into physical form. I couldn't get anybody to hear them. And now my songs have got life. My songs are on my album. People can hear them. I get to perform them. And that's just been the biggest blessing since winning The Voice. And I get to travel. I've never been out of Cape Town prior to The Voice. And now I get to travel all over the country and just meet so many amazing people. So it's been...
But researching you, you're actually really smart. Like, you did really, really well at school. And you did really, really well at university. And then I looked at your album, you spelled Restless incorrectly.
on iTunes, right? That wasn't me.
Tell me a bit about your album and what helped bring it all together.
So the album is an amalgamation of songs that I'd written prior to The Voice, and then a couple of new songs we did while on The Voice. We had 2 months to complete the album, which was insane. So we spent day in, day out writing songs, producing songs.
And where's your studio, and what's it like being in studio to record an
album? It was intimidating at first. I think the first 2 days, it took me really long to warm up to everybody being there, because I find it quite personal being in a booth and singing, and every mistake is heard, every flat note is heard, and now there are like 5 other people there watching, listening to every note.
Yeah.
It was intimidating, but I've worked with amazing guys, and they made me feel so comfortable.
You had such good songwriters, literally some of the top songwriters in the country. Yep. How much, like when you write a song when you're in studio, do they come with a written song and then you go, oh, but what about this, and then you all write together, or how does it work?
Yeah, so the majority of the songs of the album are songs I did before The Voice, and then they came in and we sort of mixed them up, added some things, taked some things out. Because the songs I wrote a couple of years ago, and like you listen back to it now, and there's some good things, but you're like, what was I thinking? And some we started from scratch, which those tend to be my favorite songs on the album now. The one Smother I'm singing, we did in like 30 minutes.
No.
Literally just poured out of us. Others we struggled for like 2-3 days.
Wow.
So it was different every time.
That's quite a special moment, I think, when you're in the studio and to be able to record a song in 30 minutes. I mean, that's you're singing from your soul at that point, you know?
Yeah.
So then how does that help with your shyness? Because that is intimidating. I know what it feels like to be in a voice booth just talking.
Yeah.
And to listen to yourself is quite... So do you feel like you've overcome your stage fear now?
I mostly have. There are days when it's bad, and there are days when it's good. But mostly, again, just the team I work with, they're incredible. They make me feel good. They make me feel comfortable. They make you realize that even if you mess up, it's okay. People mess up, you know? And I think that was the biggest thing. I'm such a perfectionist, and every little mistake, it bothers me for days on end.
Totally.
But they're just so cool. So cool about all of it.
Yeah, but then how do you deal with fans? Because I reckon you've got a lot of them.
Yeah.
All the girls in Elsie's must be literally running down that road for you.
No, it's great. I mean, from The Voice, you speak to them every day on social media and you never get to meet most of them. But whenever you run into them in public, they're like, oh, I'm the one who sent you that message that day. And it clicks and you're like, it's so cool to put a face to the name. And I mean, they've been so helpful and they've supported me from The Voice up until now. So it's, I love meeting them. Like, people always ask me, do I still go to the places I used to go to? I'm like, I do, because I love running into to the fans and speaking to them in person. Seeing how much they appreciate the music just makes me feel so much better.
Yeah, well, we're so happy to have you on the show today.
Thank you.
You are so ridiculously talented.
Thank
you've got
you so
the
much.
Most beautiful voice. We love Thank having you. You here. We look forward to having you in the kitchen. I hope that you can cook as well as
Not
you can
at
sing.
All. Not at all.
Now, while you're on your phone, head over to our social media platforms and join the conversation. We are asking, what hidden talent would you share with South Africa on a talent show? Tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the hashtag Afternoon Express or comment on our Facebook page. Craig will be back with us in the kitchen a little bit later as we put him through his paces in the kitchen with the Afternoon Express cook-along. After the break, we sit down with the consumer contestants of Tropica Island of Treasure Maldives for an exclusive insight into their first experience of arriving on the island. And I might do my secret talent a little bit later. We'll be right back. Express yourself.
Via Tropica, follow the entry details on the pack and you could win the grand prize of a Kia Picanto. For competition T's and C's, visit tropica.co.za.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, the first episode of Tropica Island of Treasure Season 8 aired on SABC 3 last night, and we were introduced to the 7 consumers who made it through the nationwide auditions, beating thousands to stand a chance of fame and fortune. And now we're lucky enough to have some of them in the studio. Welcome, guys. Lovely to have you with us. We're so excited to have you here.
Thank you. Thank you.
So tell me about the day you got the call telling you that you were going to be a contestant on Tropica Island of Treasure.
Well, for me, Bonnie, I missed the call. So I got a voicemail message from Kat on some, Nondu, you just missed out on an opportunity of a lifetime. We could have gone to an island, it could have been smooth, but now here we are in your voicemail. And I was like, oh my goodness.
What?
I panicked, and I was like, how do I
like, oh my gosh, what was I even doing missing his call?
So yeah, it was a bit dramatic for me.
Well, you're lucky you checked your messages because I'm so bad at checking messages. I get like last year's message today.
No, he left quite a few, so it was impossible not to. But yeah.
Okay, and you, how did it feel?
I got a call, and then it was before my exam, so I was pretty psyched about that. And I just didn't know who else to talk to but my mother. Yeah. So when I called my mother, she was like, focus on your exam. Don't worry about it. It's probably a scam. Okay.
Anyone else want to share their experience?
Yeah, I was amazed when Kat called me, I'm like, he's like, hey, are you ready to do kizomba and salsa dancing in the sand? I'm like, who's this? It should be my dance coach or somebody. I'm like, who's spanking me? And then he says like, Mark Anthony, you're going to the Maldives. I'm like, ah! Yeah, man.
Now let's talk about the Maldives. I've been so honored to go to the Maldives. I went on to Survivor there, so it was under harsh conditions compared to you guys' conditions. I mean, you guys were living the high life. Tell me what it felt like arriving on the island.
It was absolutely beautiful. Like I've said all along, Google did definitely not do it justice. Yeah. It was so picturesque. It was insane.
It's exquisite, huh?
Yeah. I always say it's literally like you're in Pinterest. Yeah. Everything you see on Pinterest, you're seeing live, and it's unbelievable.
Exactly. And for me, I'm someone who loves music and dance, and the welcomes were exactly that.
Yes.
Drums and everything, like, I'm like, okay.
It was a five-star hotel as well.
The villas, oh gosh.
Amazing. As soon as I arrived in the hotel, I was just like, I saw, you know, the complimentary. And then I saw the jacuzzi and then the whole rope thing. So I was like, yeah, shiny.
So what happens in the Maldives stays in the Maldives, right? So tell me about just the experience of knowing that millions of people are going to watch you on television. Do you feel like a lot of the stuff that you were doing was like, I'm now performing for the whole of South Africa? Or did that fall out the window and you were just your wretched self?
I think that's what we're all feeling now, is that we actually like, that happened, but now what are they going to use? We don't know. Mm. We said it in the moment.
Yeah, I think it's actually also pretty nerve-wracking knowing that you come in telling yourself that, okay, in front of South Africa, make sure you look pretty while you do the challenges, but when it's time, you get all out the door.
Yeah, and you feel like, what if the people watching at home think this looks so easy? Because a lot of the stuff you'll watch and think, oh, I could do that. But wait until you're in the Maldives. The sun is beating on you and you have to do the challenge. Absolutely. It's not what it looks like.
What about the possibility of winning R1 million? I mean, isn't that insane?
I'm just thinking about all the shopping I can do.
Like, and all the investments.
It makes people very competitive.
It does. Were you surprised at how competitive you were?
Yeah.
Or did you go in knowing you were like, I'm competitive, I'm here to win? Or were you just a bit shocked?
For me, I went in very open-minded and I said, I'm just gonna have a lot of fun, and the Maldives is somewhere I always wanted to go. And then during the challenges, I was like, actually, I just want to win.
I went there with the mindset of, you know what, I'm a guy and there's too many girls, so are we gonna win? But then once I got there, I realized that it's actually not the case.
Girls always show up, though. I'm just really sad you went in there thinking that.
A lot of guys did. Mark, look at you.
I'm about to challenge you to a pillow fight. Actually, for saying that. Well, guys, what do you think the audience can look forward to for the rest of the season of it?
Definitely a lot of drama, a lot of tears.
And a lot of spice.
Oh, really?
There's always spice.
And it comes in unexpected moments from unexpected people.
Okay. Well, we'll definitely be watching. But you're not going anywhere because I've got a little game for you. Just, I want to see how really prepared you were for those challenges. Okay.
So we should challenge you.
Yeah, you can challenge me. He's challenged me already. So we've met the contestants and wish them all the best as they get paired up with the celebs and face some crazy challenges and twists, all in the race to win a smooth R1 million. But we're not done with them yet. Join us later as we test them in the kitchen with a challenge of our own.
Buy a Tropica, follow the entry details on the pack, and you could win the grand prize of a Kia Picanto. For competition T's and C's, visit tropica.co.za.
Afternoon Express, and of course it's Tuesday with our fabulous Tuesday cook-along. And in the kitchen we have our sensational guest, Craig, the amazing singer, and then our lovely chef, Clem. And Vaughn Bizzle and I, we haven't been in the kitchen for a very long time. Because you know what they say, if you can't handle the heat, get out of the kitchen.
How are you in the kitchen? Have you got heat to give? Can you handle it?
I'm really terrible. If I'm giving any heat, I'm burning the kitchen down. So
really?
I'm bad. I'm really bad.
Wow.
So we get to teach you a thing or two today.
Yes, please. I'd love to learn.
Perfect.
All right. You ready?
Okay.
So we're going to start by making a dough, but we're doing a Middle Eastern dough, which is really great because
I love making dough.
Yeah.
How are you doing with that in 2018?
Love making dough.
It's 20. Get green. Are you?
Yeah. It's kind of feeling like it. It's feeling like that a lot. Good. Yeah.
So now we're going to just make some dough. So. Middle Eastern dough, well, if we talk about how they originally came about making this dough, they used yak yogurt or milk in it, and it naturally fermented, which is really great. We're going to do exactly the same today. So no bicarb, no yeast, we're using yogurt. So I've got some flour in here. I'm going to add some salt and pepper, always. Oh, while I'm doing this, how about you guys start rolling out your dough? So I'm kind of looking for like a kind of like a rough rugby ball-ish.
One piece or two pieces?
You got 2 pieces because you can roll mine out as well.
Oh, cool. Awesome.
So
you're I'll roll in your dough.
There we go.
You roll in dough, right?
I cried like a
roller, Craig.
Dough.
You got this, right?
Yeah.
Oh, Bonnie, there's another little roller there for Craig. My great granny's chapati roller.
Sorry, my bad. How thin do you want, or how flat? Yeah, how thin?
I like this question because it's not going to go into the oven. We're going to grill it on a griddle pan. So you don't want it too thin.
Hair?
I like that.
Oh.
You don't want it too thin because you want your filling to be able to be secure inside there. And you don't want it too thick because else it's going to be doughy and uncooked.
I'm so good at this kitchen thing.
You really got this kitchen thing down.
Yeah,
I know.
I'm good at this dough thing.
Yeah.
Okay, you guys are doing a good job.
I'm good at making the dough.
I didn't even think mine is a shape.
Let me see. You know what? You're going to eat this however you make it. That's totally up to you. So I'm going to put the heat on salon. You guys are doing a great job. I'm going to actually start the filling.
Oh, there you go. You know what? This is actually my favorite
way
to eat.
Mine is so thin.
Mediterranean food is the best.
It is the best.
Mine is so thin, it's actually stuck to the table.
Oh,
You got some extra flour there.
See, I did it.
There you go.
See, that's exactly what I'm saying. You're gonna eat the one that you make, okay? You've got some flour. You know
make
what?
Me. Make me.
Craig, can I get the spinach? Oh, you guys are really busy. Can I get the spinach from you? So we're using... Oh, look at you. Thank you so much. We're using Swiss chard.
Love.
You could use... Give me some examples.
Kale.
Yes.
Baby spinach.
Uh-huh. Slaw.
Yes. Craig, you want to give it a try?
Can you really?
No, I think that covers well.
Kale slaw.
Kale slaw.
Absolutely. So any nice hearty leaf, or you can use the baby spinach, which is really great. But it's going to give us nice texture. Guys, by the way, do you know why we're making this dish specifically? Yeah. Craig's a vegetarian.
Yes.
Oh, samesies, actually. Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice enough.
I'm
not a vegan, otherwise I would have told everybody about it already.
You were gobbling down that steak last night.
I haven't eaten meat or chicken in a year.
I'm joking, this darling. Year. I'm joking.
I'm joking.
Oh my goodness. Okay. Some olive oil going into the pan. Oh, guys.
All right.
Then let's start talking about the spinach. Actually, we can add the spinach immediately. Jeannie, can you do that for me? And then let's start talking. Then go to the pan. Absolutely.
Oh,
you
into
don't actually
the pan.
Add any water. There's moisture in spinach. I see a lot of people end up putting spinach into a pan or to a pot with a lot of water.
The whole thing?
All of
it. Yeah, because spinach has so much water.
And then you
notice
that the water's always green at the end. That's all the nutrients and all the goodness that cooks out.
It's gone, yeah.
It's gone.
It cooks all the way down.
So we're also saving water.
Yeah.
So no water, just
this
just
is
oil.
An amazing, amazing recipe. And of course, if you want this recipe as well, because this dish is actually going to be divine. What is the keyword again, Clem?
Eat.
The keyword is eat. And all you need to do is send the keyword eat to 33650. And there you will get all the ingredients and the shopping list all delivered to your phone. SMSs cost R1.50 each. T's and C's apply, and free SMSs do not apply.
Look at that dodo.
Okay.
Look at that dodo.
I like that.
Look at that dodo.
Craig, how's yours doing? No, Craig, I like you.
show us your dough?
I'm going for an Afrika-inspired.
Nice.
Oh, lovely.
I like it.
All right, so, Jeannie, your dough's looking good, so can I ask you to help me out with the filling?
Absolutely.
Cool, yeah. So tomato paste going in there.
Sure, into where?
Into our pan
into
with the spinach.
Okay.
And then can I'm going to go mix? In with some, I got some garam masala, or you could use cumin or coriander. You just want to get a nice earthy flavor in there. Some nice. Smoked paprika. You know what? I'm going to actually spice up a little later. I would add like 3 chilies to this one, but we're being a little mild.
No, come, let's do it.
Okay, we're going to get to the chilies in a bit. So
can I mix this while I'm going?
Are you exactly. a chili fan?
I am, absolutely.
Really? So
that makes me really excited, yeah.
I love it. Excited, okay, cool.
Okay, some roasted garlic, get it going in there. Let me get the chili.
You're actually very fortunate that for the past few weeks we've been doing a little chili challenge, and I think we've been doing a bit too much, which makes you very fortunate, because we're not going to ask you to do it.
There we go. Chili going in. So,
okay.
Can I put my dough on this griddle?
Not yet. Because what I'm going to do, Jeannie, that's looking amazing. A little bit of
thank you.
Olives going in.
Nice stirring, Jeannie.
Okay, cool.
Look at you.
All right, so now we're going
to
get
I love when you get into these hyperactive moments. You actually make my day.
I'm hyperactive today. Excuse me.
I ready to put your dough.
Yeah.
So what you're gonna do now is you've got tongs your side, Bon and Craig. Yep. Jeannie, you got your tongs here. You're gonna add some of this filling. It doesn't have to cook all the way down, right? It's gonna cook again on the griddle pan. Add a little bit of dough. Can I do a little demonstration?
Please do.
A little bit over here.
Okay.
Like there. Let me do it over here so you can all see.
Yeah.
And then you got some feta.
Oh yes, okay. Lots of cheese.
Mozzarella.
Yeah.
I'm being a little skimping with the cheese. There we go.
You don't need to skip with cheese.
What else have we got here? We've got some, you guys have some roasted tomatoes. You can add that to it.
Ooh.
I'm going to skip on that one right now.
Okay.
It's okay if it sticks to the table. It's fine.
That actually looks so delicious.
It is.
This
it's so
is
good.
Divine. This is such a good recipe. Trust me on this one. This is one that you want to remember and cook this one for a night out. You know when you, because don't you feel like sometimes when you entertain at home, I don't know about you, well, no, not you, because you said you were terrible cook, but you always get stuck making the same things over and over again. But when you entertain, every now and then, shake things
challenge
up a bit.
Challenge yourself.
And bring completely different recipes to the table.
It's funny,
this is
when
one of
I,
those.
When I entertain at home, I use that as an opportunity to challenge myself.
Yes. Yeah,
I love
but
that.
It's when I cook for my family that I just cook the same old stuff.
All right. This actually isn't my recipe, by the way. My amazing culinary administrator, she came up with this, and she's like, I'm inspired. I can go vegetarian if I'm gonna eat like this every night.
Yeah,
okay.
This is really good.
So can we make our own?
Yeah, please do.
Because we feel a bit left out here.
No, go
thanks
for it, guys.
Thanks for facilitating.
I'm sorry, there we go.
And thanks for taking us through the steps of what you were doing.
Bonnie, you are on fire today.
Yes, right? Cheeky. Now, I want to know from you, when did you decide to go vegetarian?
Alice.
It's been over 2 years. You mentioned before, so I was vegan for a couple of years. To The Voice.
Really?
Then I was on the show and things got a little odd. They didn't really cater for vegans, but then they had cheese and eggs and whatever. So then I became vegetarian.
Yeah.
Fell off the wagon somewhere along the way, but then I started getting back onto it. But it's been a couple of years on and off.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
And do you notice a lot of health benefits from being vegan or vegetarian?
Absolutely. That is one of the main reasons
really?
I decided to stick with it. Yeah, you feel so much healthier. I get sick a lot less. My skin
really?
Cleared up.
Amazing.
And that's like, as hard as it gets, I always remind myself, I feel so much better now than
do
I did.
You feel lighter and just
absolutely.
Happy
wow.
energy-wise
yes.
as well.
Absolutely. It doesn't help that prior I was...
It must change your spiritual disposition as well.
It does. And I think the thing is, that happened to me on the journey. So it wasn't beforehand where I was like, these are the reasons
sure.
I want to become vegan or vegetarian. But as you do it and you learn more about it, it's quite enlightening and it's fulfilling as
yeah.
well.
Amazing. So, you know, we're asking all the viewers at home, if you had to share any kind of particular skill with the world, especially on a talent show like that, what would it be? So we really hope that you're getting busy on your social media devices like your Facebook and Twitter and letting us know exactly how you feel. If you had to go on a talent competition and share any kind of talent, what would it be? To anything, Bunny, don't worry.
Yeah.
Use your words.
I don't know. I just
and for you?
Maybe like chopping with, like super fast and with super sharp knives without looking.
Yeah.
Can I maybe equal that count? And I gradually just progressed like bigger knives, like a adventure about chopping with a sword.
Okay.
No?
So now if I had to go on the show that you were on, and then all of the judges are turned around, I would do a Britney impersonation and then hope that they would all turn around and say yes, just thinking I was Britney. I was like, oh baby, baby.
Are you serious?
No.
That is your special talent.
Oh baby, baby.
They could
run in an instant. Okay, sure. Baby, we're gonna be back after the break with some more delicious Turkish food.
Childhood cancer is the second most common cause of death amongst children in South Africa. One in every 500 children in South Africa are diagnosed with childhood cancer.
My daughter was diagnosed. She's got myopothelial carcinoma of the soft tissue, which is in the tummy. It's very sad to find out that your child has cancer because I never thought that it would happen to me.
Chalk is very helpful because children must be treated here the whole week. So for you to travel every day, going home, coming back, so chalk is helpful there because you can come stay at chalk. They cook for the children healthy food, and then they also provide with transport for people who struggle.
Chalk is one of South Africa's leading organizations who aid families who are affected by childhood cancer. Afternoon Express, together with My School, are committed to helping Chalk raise funds for a newly refurbished home away from home. You can get involved by signing up for your free virtual My School, My Village, My Planet card today. Download the My School app, select Chalk as one of your beneficiaries, and you will automatically be entered into a weekly loot.co.za competition.
Chalk is a big support. We made family here, Chalk, and I don't think I would know what I would have done if it wasn't for them.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Of course, it's a fabulous Tuesday cook-along. We've got our sensational Craig in the loft, who is possibly one of the best singers in the country at the moment. Then Bon Bizzle is literally causing havoc.
I'm so lit. I'm excited to be back in the cook-along vibe.
I know. It's been a while since you've been with us.
You are like... Whoa.
What do you do on your Tuesdays, by the way, when you're not in here with us?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Yes, I'd like to know.
I'm talent.
Craig, what do you do on your off time?
I mostly just stay at home, read a couple books, write music, visit my friends. But the thing is, I'm the only musician in my friend group, so I'm at home during the day, and then most of them are at home in the evening when I'm usually working. So it's hard. Yeah. I just stay at home most of the time. Everybody else is at work. Everybody's got regular jobs. So
are you quite a bookworm as well?
I am. But the thing is, I struggle, but I sort of push through. So it's not something that comes easy. I get bored, but like, I know what the end goal is, and so I sort of push through. Yeah.
And what is your writing process? Because I suppose reading a lot really probably helps a lot with writing music. How do you write? And I always ask musicians this. Like, if there's some kind of a... Do you think of what the melody is, or do you think of what the words are, like, for how the song is going to end up?
Yeah. It's quite weird. So because I don't have any musical training, a lot of the songs I wrote, they just come to me in the middle of the night or in the morning.
But how do you hear it? As a finished song?
Not as a finished song. So I hear a chorus or melody or a couple of lyrics, and I put it down in my... So the voice notes on my phone is, like, this full of tracks.
Yeah.
And then I'd usually sit home and then go on my computer, go on my program and finish it. But with the album, it was the first time that we wrote sort of with the intention of finishing a song. And I then learned how to get into a studio, decide what the story is I want to tell, how I want to tell it. And so I've now learned sort of both ways of doing it, the haphazard way that I usually do it and then the proper way as well.
Wow.
When you are in the shower, what is your go-to song? Obviously, you don't shower at the moment in Cape Town singing a long song. But I mean, when you're in your shower in Joburg, what would be your go-to song?
Yeah, funny enough, it's usually some rap. Kanye, I'm a big Kanye West fan.
Really? So come, give us, drop us a line.
I quite lit in the shower. I went to Jesus Walks. So, Jesus walks, God show me the way because the devil's trying to break me down. Jesus walks with me. I'm really bad at rapping. I kind of
like it. All I'm trying to say is get back, click, clack, pow.
I will learn
your raps and you can do the beautiful vocal and I'll be your rapper.
We are just as bad as rapping, but we do it all the time.
We're basically rappers.
I think everybody is.
Okay.
I'm quite G.
Wow. Are you quite G'd up from the feet up?
Oh, yeah.
Cool. How's it going?
We're cooking.
Yes, we're cooking. You want to turn those over for me? Then you got some tongs.
Tongs.
Yeah.
Nice.
Thanks. Look at that. And you want it to get nice and crispy.
Oh, that is delish.
And it's like, are the spices coming out a little bit? Can you smell it already? Remember, we didn't cook the spinach so much. I was going to wilt even more while I was cooking on the grill pan. Let's talk about the cauliflower. So we got some cauliflower. Look at this trend. Cauliflower's not dying. People are still loving cauliflower.
Yeah.
Do you know that my great-grandfather used to be known as the Cauliflower King?
How come?
He was a farmer and he used to make the best cauliflower. Yeah. That's my grandpa right there. Cauliflower King. It's where I get the blue blood from.
Okay. Cauliflower going in, and then we got a little bit of cayenne pepper, seeing as we all like the chili, we're fine with that. Mm-hmm. A little bit of turmeric, because we are loving turmeric now.
Anti-aging.
There we go.
Save the rest for me, I'm just going to down it.
I'll give you some more. And then smoked paprika, that's going in. So you want to give it a nice toss, just to get like, I know it's all dry and it's not really sticking, but you want it just to coat all the cauliflower.
Right.
Get a bit of the spice on there.
And was the cauliflower completely dry before that, or did you just have it a bit moist?
No, there's a dry.
To pick up the...
There's no water on this.
Okay, it's come on, dry. Like how much water would you need to make dry that moist? Like literally one teaspoon.
Not even. Do it while the cauliflower is dry, because you don't want it to clump to the cauliflower. If you do that, you can do it at home, it's going to be a little heavier. Then it's really going to go a bit cakey, a little biscuity, and we're going to do this to keep it nice and light. So, here we go. Cauliflower in, how's your oil looking? Oh, do you want to test the oil for me? Oh, that's what you would not do. Do you want to test it for me? Yep. And it's sizzling.
It's perfect.
So that's good. So let's turn it up a little bit.
Yeah.
And...
Aren't you pleased that I remembered that that's how to do it? Imagine I did it wrong.
And in it goes. So, Craig, do you have any like go-to vegetarian dishes? Because normally when you go to dinner party, they normally give you like a stuffed pepper or a stuffed mushroom.
Yeah.
Like, is it like, what do you do at home?
I essentially live off of Chinese food. Because they make every option in vegetarian as well. So, like have chow mein today.
Very creative about it,
And Indian food as well. It's one of the sort of types of food that also caters to vegetarians a lot.
I love Indian vegetarian, so, because they do a lot of chickpeas, a lot of potatoes, spinach.
Yep.
Yeah, awesome.
Talking about chickpeas, what I've done is I've made a lentil hummus, and I've taken the chickpeas out, and because I bring a little bit of Cape Town for you, I made a curried lentil hummus dip. Nice. You want to actually try it? You use it as a little tiny bowl?
Yeah.
It is
So good.
So it's so hummus is just chickpeas, olive oil, and garlic reduced and made into a mush.
Uh-huh.
So what have you added in there?
I've taken the chickpeas out.
That is really good.
Added the lentils to it.
Oh,
and then I cooked a little bit of onions, a little bit of curry spice.
Really spicy as well, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's great because being a vegetarian, you gotta like get that protein in there.
It is delicious.
I've never had hummus made with anything other than chickpeas, so that is that's pretty cool.
You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna make this on the show so you guys can see this. Not now. You gotta try that. That's really good.
It's delicious.
Good. This is so good.
It's delicious.
And I eat a lot of hummus. I eat it like every single day.
So
this hummus is giving me crazy eyes.
It is. It's kind of like an Indian hummus.
Yeah.
You like it? Cool. So what you're gonna do is you got the beautiful flatbreads.
Wow.
Yours are looking amazing, by the way. I've made a few because I was a little concerned. We might not get any flatbreads out today, so I made a few before the time. That's gonna be cool. So you kind of like cut it, dunk it, and I get everything in your mouth. So cauliflower, let's have a look at this. Another thing, I hate when people overcook cauliflower and it's mush.
Okay, yeah. No, then we must.
You wanna keep it a little crunchy, so let's see, we're almost there. Don't forget corn flour, which is the powder that we used, the flour we used, doesn't go brown.
So I was waiting that to look crispy and brown, no.
When people make tempura and they wait for everything to go brown and everything's overcooked.
Okay.
Tempura is not supposed to go, or cauliflower doesn't go brown. So you want to get, you kind of look at the cauliflower to see a changed texture. But I can see that's not done just yet.
That looks so good though.
Mm-hmm. It does. And the oil, don't waste that oil, because obviously the turmeric's turned that oil yellow.
Yeah.
Use that for a curry next time you cook. Super spicy. Or fry your eggs in that curried oil.
Wow.
Do you not eat eggs? Eat eggs?
Sometimes.
Sometimes, yeah, I'm obsessed.
I'm just trying to imagine frying my eggs in the curried oil, like just scrambled eggs.
We're like talking Mediterranean. They actually do cook their eggs in a spicy oil.
Yeah.
Oh.
We are so untrained.
I've got the most amazing thing at home.
Yeah.
I've got a chili olive oil. It's amazing.
Like a chili
it's
infused.
An olive oil, and then people put, and then whoever made it put chilies in it.
In it, yeah.
So it's a chili infused olive oil.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, we should make one on the show as well.
Yeah, and what about that roasted garlic? We just chuck it in a pot with olive oil. That'd be amazing.
Oh, yes.
What are your fondest memories of cooking at home, or your parents cooking, or your favorite meal as a child?
My mom's a good cook, and I think my love for Indian food comes from her. She makes the most amazing curry. So she used to cook for us all the time.
Yeah.
And now, because I'm not home a lot, whenever I come back to Cape Town, she literally puts out
a spread
every single time. Yeah. So all the food I loved when I was younger, lasagna, or you know, Sunday food, the food you get when you come from church on a Sunday.
And do you have a very musical family? Like, what happens on your Sunday lunches? Do you all end up like singing around a guitar? I always wished I had a family like that.
They love singing, they're not really good, none of them, literally, but that doesn't stop them, so there is constant singing in my house.
But did you know from a young boy that you were that good at singing?
I didn't, but my family sort of caught on, and they were the ones always trying to make me sing it. You know, every family gathering, if someone comes over, they call you out to the room, like, I just sing auntie somebody a song. And then
people would love it.
The feedback was good, and then eventually I was like, okay, maybe I've got something.
It's incredible.
Because that's quite an amazing thing. Like, imagine you've got a son that's, like, really, really talented at singing. But imagine you've got a kid that isn't and that wants to do it so badly. Like,
but
he's saying
you tell them the truth. You tell them the truth.
Tough love.
Yeah, tough love. Mm-hmm. So don't forget that we've got that live performance from Craig Lucas coming up later in the show. Plus, we're back in the kitchen with the contestants of Season 8 of Tropical Island of Treasure, Maldives.
I'm mull about this.
that you love on the side for your pleasure. I sip on you, sip on you, sip on you, sip on you till I'm wasted. So close to you, close to you, close to you, close to you, I can taste it.
Tropica, follow the entry details on the pack and you could win the grand prize of a Kia Picanto. For competition T's and C's, visit tropica.co.za.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Thank you so much for joining us. We're having so much fun with the Tropica Island of Treasure Maldives contestants in studio today that we thought we'd give them a little challenge of our own in the kitchen. So in the name of entertainment, we're going to play What's in the Box. Basically, we have this fabulous box with some strange feeling items inside. Now, you the viewers and us the presenters can see what's in the box, but the contestants can't. They'll just have to try turning it around and working it out and feeling their way through it, and let us know what's in the box. So who wants to go first? Ready, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so no sneaking peek. Okay. Okay. Uh-huh. I saw you there.
No calling fishermen.
Okay, cool. Put your hands to the sides.
Yeah, the sides, yeah.
How does it feel? Mm.
Ooh.
Mushy. Mushy.
What is this?
What is this?
Seeds.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Tell us more.
Granadilla, tropical fruit probably.
Maybe.
Papaya.
Yes. Nice one. Well done. What did it feel like feeling that?
Was
it strange?
Yeah, strange.
Okay. Are you ready? Okay. All right. Here we go.
I don't know if I'm going to be able to get both.
Are your hands reaching?
I can get
Are you
one.
Feeling a bit like Barney the dinosaur? Are you feeling anything?
Yeah. It feels like a kiwi.
It's a kiwi! Whoa! Well done. Okay.
Pressure.
You guys are good. You're on it. Alert. Okay. There you go. Aha. Okay. Mm-hmm. Ooh. No. What is it?
It's a meat cheese.
It is meat cheese.
My mom loves them, so you know.
Yeah. Well, we got you all the perfect ingredients because guess what? It's all about the tropical, it's all about the island, and it's all about treasure, right?
Yeah.
Cool, guys. So thank you so much for joining us today, and we'll be catching you on the series, and we can't wait to have you back to chat to us about your experience. So, well, that was amusing. And if you want to see these guys having more fun and being challenged more in the beautiful Maldives, then tune in to SABC3 on Monday at 7:30 p.m. for the next exciting episode.
Get a taste of the smooth island life and win big with Tropica Island of Treasure Maldives. Buy a Tropica, follow the entry details on the pack, and you could win daily airtime prizes, American Tourister luggage for your next adventure, vouchers from loot.co.za to shop the hot daily deals online, and the grand prize of a Kia Picanto. For competition T's and C's, visit tropica.co.za. And don't forget to watch Tropica Island of Treasure Maldives every Monday at 7:30 p.m. on SABC3.
Ah, Maldives is always a good idea. And now dinner is served, and the only thing left to enjoy is some live music. Here to perform his single, Smother, it's Craig Lucas.
Try to resist it. How did I? missing. Now it's 3 a.m. and I'm calling again. Will you listen? I'm under pressure. How do I measure up to all of the guys that you love on the side for your pleasure? I'll sip on you, sip on you, sip on you, sip on you till I'm wasted. So close to you, close to you, close to you, close to you, I can taste it. So go ahead and smother, and go ahead and smother me now. It don't bother me that I can't breathe you, taking me down. Go ahead and smother, and go ahead and smother me now. Can't get you off of me, this ecstasy. You playing it cool like this gives you some sweet satisfaction. But I'm only human and I don't know what I'm doing. But I know that I need you, and so don't walk away. I'll sip on you, sip on you, sip on you, sip on you till I'm wasted. So close to you, close to you, close to you, close to you, I can taste it. So go ahead and smile and go ahead and smile me now. It don't bother me that I can't breathe, you've taken me down. And go ahead and smile and go ahead and smile me now. Can't get you off.
Wow. Love it.
Where are you?
Love it. Please come, you're hiding. Your food's ready.
You've literally got the most beautiful, beautiful voice.
Thank you're
you.
Phenomenal.
You've got the kind of voice that I just want to keep on hearing more.
Thank you so much.
So your album, Restless, is yes. out now. People must buy it.
It is.
Online.
It is, yeah.
And in stores?
It's in stores, all music stores along the country, and then it's on iTunes, Google Play, Deezer, Tidal.
And how has it been received?
Really well, which has been amazing because, you know, you're on a show like The Voice and you sing other people's songs, and when people actually appreciate your own music, it's really, really, it's an amazing feeling, and people love the album, particularly that song.
Well, you deserve all of it.
We love you. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank
you so much, Clem, for making such amazing music. And just a reminder that we will be off air tomorrow, making food. We'll be off air tomorrow due to the cricket. We'll return to your screens again on Thursday at 4:30 right here on SABC3. Clem, thank you for the music. Thank you for the music, my darling.
It's music to our ears, darling.
It's nice to have you.
Afternoon Express, made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.